What's up, man?
What? Lysol injections.
You didn't see Trump yesterday? He said you should just inject yourself with Lysol.
I like it.
Yeah, you gotta bring that up.
Lysol injections.
Yeah, right there on there. See, look at me giving you nuggets of fun.
Lysol injections. Trump said that yesterday?
Yeah, he said you should just inject yourself with Lysol and that would cure the corona.
It's gonna be on, man. You tell people. You
awesome.
Let them know.
Thanks, buddy. That's great. Teamwork makes the dream work.
That's right. Check.
Great, thank you.
He knows I'm not responsible to watch him. He dances to the beat of a different drummer, folks. Anyways. Thank you. Okay, I got it. What? Right. All right, then hit it. That was right on cue, man. I like that. Good morning, Lori Johnson, John Ruswick, Cheech. Cheech, Cheech, Cheech. What's happening, people? It is Friday, April 24th. Can you believe it? We made it to April 24th, 2020. That's 4242020. For those of you who like digits, even numbers, right? Right? Is Is zero an even number or an odd number? Listen, for those of you who don't know this, this is the Subaru Steve Show. Good morning, Paul Johnstone. Nice to see you. And you know what time it is. That's right. I'm Subaru Steve of the Subaru Steve AnthonyV Show. AnthonyV is normally sitting right here. He's here somewhere, but not here somewhere. He's somewhere out there. But anyways, it is coffee time. We do this silly show Monday through Friday. Saturday, tomorrow morning, we'll do your weekend update. And if you're watching this right now, do me a favor, tag a friend or share. Actually, share, because that'll tag a lot of friends in its own way. What is going on, man? You're not here, but that doesn't mean I can't talk to you, right? In fact, right now, I'm probably going to get the answers I like. Look, he's here. He even brought his own coffee cup in. Check it out. This is the AnthonyV official coffee mug of the day. It's pretty cool. He brought coffee in because he's not here for coffee time. I don't get it. I don't get it. They don't pay me to get it, I guess. I don't know. What? Miguel, you're slipping up there, man. You're really slipping, Miguel. I don't want to have to think about replacing you. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I don't think you do. Miguel, can you ask Pablo to find Anthony V, maybe? That would really be appreciated. Okay. So, we are here to inform, motivate, and bring a smile to that face. Yvonne, how are you? I understand you're getting married. Yvonne up in the Washington, D.C. area. Doing amazing things up there. Used to work down here as well. Got a question for everybody. The question is, what would you like to see more of on these shows? I know you'd like to see more of Anthony V, who's not here. He's here, but not here. But what would you like to see more of? What kind of content can we bring to you? What can we do to make your day, to start your day off right? That's really what this is all about. It's not about us. It's really not. Yeah, we got our names up there. We got our names down here. But it's really not about us. It's about you, the viewer. I mean you. I'm looking right at you, so you know I mean you. What can we do for you? We'd love to know. Do some birthday shout-outs right now. We're going to keep things rolling right along. I want to talk about Mr. Brian Waltz up in Albany, New York. Today's his birthday, and you can find, if you're in Albany, look up Armory Garage Auto Sales. He's also friends with Jonathan Dawson. True story. True story, really is. Oh, hey, welcome. Thanks for joining us, man. Come on and have a seat.
What stay? I gotta run home.
You can run home after the show.
Emergency. Gotta run home.
Okay, well then.
Gotta run home. But everybody, make sure you finish the day 24-0.
Everything all right?
Keep you.
Do we need to end
up? No.
Okay. All right.
Sounds like that, man.
Sounds like he forgot to put his underwear on today. Got to run home. You know, those adult diapers don't last but so long. Caitlin, Post, Greg, Watson, Caitlin. I felt like I just saw you a minute ago. Surely you're around here somewhere. She works here as well in our service department. Hey, listen, birthdays. Armory Garage Auto Sales own Brian Waltz knows Jonathan Dawson. Today is his birthday. Give him a shout out. My man, David M. Everett II. He's got the coolest profile picture on Facebook that I've seen. It's a Knight Templar. I love it. I love it, man. I love it. And he's on the West Coast in Oceanside, California. That's what I said. Yep. Cade Allred. He's into sales as well. Can you believe it? Sales at Rocky Mountain Yeti. And I thought, what's he selling, Bigfoot? Is he selling Big Feet Yetis? But no, that's another automobile dealership. They sell Jeep, Dodge, Chryslers, and he lives in Afton, Wyoming. Wyoming, a beautiful country, beautiful state out there, you know. Mike DC. What the heck does DC stand for, Mike? Are you in the District of Columbia? Do you not have a last name? So you adopted the two letters? He's in Greenville, Texas. And one of his favorite phrases, I absolutely love this, is an idea without action is only a dream. Man, think about that. An idea without action, it's only a dream. And folks, let's make those dreams become reality. Together we can do it. Even alone you can do it as long as you put focus on that. So now I'm realizing I got the whole show to myself right now because he has an emergency. He's Anthony B is attending to. So I guess I can just move him aside here and make a little, hey, I like to make a little change here. Hello. Hello. Anyways, this is going to be an unusual show. At least he's got life hacks there. And what else are we going to do here? I'm going to have a drink of coffee real quick. Stay here if you're here right now. Tag a friend. Let us know you're here. Let's see. Subscribe on YouTube. I did a short little video yesterday about subscribing on YouTube. We really need your help. Let me get these mics just set just right. You know, speaking of microphones, I understand Donald Trump yesterday, according to Dennis Wright over in our Chevrolet building here at RK, RK Auto, we have Chevrolet, we have Subaru, we have a huge used car division as well. But Dennis Wright said President Trump yesterday suggested that everybody get a Lysol injection. I don't know about you, but there's something not right in my mind that says to inject Lysol into my bloodstream. Now, if the president's willing to do that, I'll be more interested. But if he's not doing it, I'm not doing it. No. Tremendous idea, really tremendous, but not for me. National days today. It is National Arbor Day, and I believe that's a tree hugger's holiday. National Arbor Day. National Teach Children to Save Day. Now, my wife, my lovely wife, Carla, has a little piggy bank for my newest grandson, Christian, and the change I used to get every night that goes into my big piggy bank now goes in his. So I think it's great that we teach children how to save, but yeah, whatever. I'm not going to go there. National Hairball Awareness Day. Well, as you know, my hairball just left. That's Anthony V. Has a family thing to attend to at home. National Hairball Awareness Day. You'll not commonly see him do something like this. That's what you would call a hairball. Cats typically have them. And that's a hairball. National Pigs in a Blanket Day. You know, I never understood this. Pigs in a blanket. Have you ever seen a real pig in a blanket? Now, some of you have little potbelly pet pigs, and you probably wrap those up. If you do, post those photos. I have a niece, Jamie Ritzenthaler, up in West Virginia. She's got all kinds. She's like Ellie Mae Clampett. She's got all kinds of critters around the place. Jamie, I encourage you to take one of those potbelly pigs, wrap it up in a blanket, and send me a photo. In fact, all of you out there who have pigs in a blanket, send me your photos. I'd love to share them as well. I'd love to see them first, and then maybe share them. Brandon Kaufman. How are you, my friend? Nice to see you. Moving right along, something Subaru, Anthony V is supposed to talk about something Subaru or Subaru stories, which, let's see, let me think about something Subaru. Something Subaru, Subaru stories. I guess if I'm going to talk about Subaru right now, I'll point out that we're leasing my wife's Forester, and I was leasing my Outback, but I just refinanced my Outback into a purchase because I know I'm going to keep the Outback. I love the new 2020 Outback. New technology, 11.6-inch tablet-like screen. I mean, it's like basically having something like this on your dashboard. Not up high where you can't see over it and it blocks your road view, but down right on the dashboard where you can be driving, and if you need to, touchscreen, touch things on there like the radio station, the navigation system. It is really one of the coolest things. They've increased the horsepower on it, so the prior Outbacks and Foresters had 175 horsepower on the 2.5 liter four-cylinder engine. Now it has 182, which is plenty of power. I'm 67 years old. I don't need to be flying around like I was in the WRX. So I find that this new engine is great. So that's my something Subaru. Then I'm going to roll on into my message here. And I have two messages. I put one aside for later. It's a quote I thought really neat today. But Oprah Winfrey said this. And I thought it was very interesting. When I saw it, it caught my eye. Be thankful for what you have, and you'll end up having more. If you concentrate on what you don't have, you'll never, ever have enough. You know, I tell people all the time, and they look at me like, yeah, right, but I say, I have everything I need, and I'm thankful. I'm thankful to have everything that I need, and I end up having more. So what she said is true. Be thankful for what you have, you'll end up having more. If I try not to spend time thinking on things I don't have, because I find that a waste of time, and you can never get time back. I try not to spend time thinking about what I don't have. It's a waste of time. And again, she's right with her quote. If you concentrate on what you don't have, you'll never, ever have enough. So be thankful for what you have, and and keep moving along. Smile. Smile throughout your day. Help other people. Look for the opportunity to do something for somebody else. Like me right now, filling in for Anthony B. I could be joking him right now. I could be knocking him down. Well, it's kind of hard to do because he's so short. I mean, he just rolls over like a weebles wobble, but they don't fall down kind of thing. That's what Anthony, you know me, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? I think you do. But anyways, what are you most thankful for? Think about it for a second. What are you? You. Yes, you. What are you most thankful for? Because therein is your blessing. Think about that for a second. Whatever you're most thankful for is your blessing. Lori, I see your message. If you need help today, if you need to reach out to me or Anthony V, you know you always can. You're our number one fan. You can give Anthony V a call at 757, any of you can, 406-4701. Or you can call me after the show at 757-793-6656. I want to make sure I give you the real number. But I'm here to help. If your son, I will definitely put you in prayer. Maybe before the show ends, maybe I'll do a quick prayer. You know what? I like that. That's a great idea. I don't have an ink pen. I have all things. I got ink pens everywhere, but not here. I'm going to remember that. I'm going to keep my hands together to remember that. Life hacks. Well, I got to pull my hands apart right now. Life hacks for today. So Anthony yesterday talked about listening to your favorite song before going to bed. It helps you sleep better, wake up easier, and enhance your mood for the upcoming day. I don't know about that one. Think about it, though. Listen to your favorite song before you go to bed and see how well you sleep. Then let us know. Today's life hack, April 24th, 2020. Yes, I just scratched my head, it itched. The numbers on your toaster. You ever thought about your toaster for a minute? There are numbers on your toaster. And the numbers on your toaster are the amount of minutes you want to toast for, not the degrees of toastiness. My whole life has been a sham. So somebody took today's life hack, printed it up professionally, and put their opinion on it, the opinion of their life being a sham. The numbers on the toaster are generally 1 through 5, 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I don't know why there's a 0. If it's for the number of minutes you toast, if you put it at 0, put the bread in, I guess it pops right back up. But that's for the number of minutes you want it to toast for, not the degrees of toastiness. And I would almost disagree with that. If you're setting it for a minute and the toastiness comes out the way you like it, then you know 2 minutes is going to overtoast it, and it's not going to be the toastiness that you're looking for. Yeah, whatever, right? You got that. Anthony B's life hacks. It's going to be a quick show today, folks. It's 8:15, and I'm almost done. What's happening? I'm not going to talk about deferring your payments. I'm not going to talk about taxes or Mother's Day being May 10th next month. I guess I just did talk about it, but I really want to talk about this, the Subaru Guru Cruise. And I really want to highlight this because this is something we're going to do. We're planning for it right now. It's going to be 9 months from now. And no, not mine, 11 months from now, in March of 2021, you have time to book a room on what's going to probably be one of the cleanest ships sailing, Royal Caribbean. The cruise industry is going to recover. They're going to suffer. They are suffering right now. They're going to suffer for a little bit. But I tell you what, those of you who cruise again are probably going to be on the cleanest ships in the world, because in order for a cruise ship industry to survive, they've got to make improvements. And I think we're going to see a lot. Number one, they're going to have Subaru Steve and Anthony V in the Caribbean in March of next year. And we'd love to have you follow us along, either online on the Tuesday morning or be with us every day during the cruise. It's what, a four-night cruise to the Bahamas. And we're going to go to Nassau. It's going to be a lot of fun. We're going to do the show Tuesday morning at 8 a.m. deckside. And I'm pretty sure they will... The cruise, what do they call the person, the host or the cruise director, will probably have us a really nice setup. I'd love to have you there. We'll probably interview people there that came on the cruise for us. That's the best thing we can do is share that with the world, let them know that you were there. So think about it. Give Cruise Ship Skip a call at 757-431-2111. That's 431-2111. And let them know, say, Skip, I want to learn more about the Guru Cruise, the Subaru Guru Cruise. And I think that's about it. I covered everything. You know, Enrique Collin was going to call me this morning, and I think he did, but I was up early watching Rise and Grind at 5:30 in the morning. Enrique, if I missed your call, you know what, we'll do it again tomorrow morning early. But not 5:30, because that's when I tune into Glenn Lundy at Rise and Grind. He's the guy that gave us his planners. And tell you what, those are phenomenal books. If you want to know more about the planners, just let me know. Give us a heart right now, and I'll show you my planner. Brian Waltz, happy birthday. You missed your shout out, dude. Today, Brian Waltz up in Albany, New York, friends with Jonathan Dawson on Facebook at the Armory Garage Auto Sales up in New York. If you're looking for some cars, you want to contact Brian Waltz on his birthday. Brian, type your phone number in if you want phone calls from people. This is your chance to shine. People are hearing about you down here in Virginia Beach, Virginia, and across the globe. That's right. I think that's about it. I think we're going to wrap this up now. What do you think? Where's my coffee? Oh, there it is. Got to have some more coffee because it is coffee time. Like Andy B would say, what are you for? I don't know. It's the beat of the music. But yes, it is time to end the show. So Pablo, Miguel, we thank you. But Miguel, I need you to hit the music for us so I can end the show. Thank you, my man. I appreciate you. Appreciate all you do, man. I can always count on you. Pablo, I don't know, but look, today is the 24th. Are you 24-0? Are you? Are you really 24-0? I think some of you are. And a few of you may not. Maybe you're 23-0. Maybe you're 22-0. Don't give up. Because you know what? Today's a new day. You can do new things. You can be successful. Put it in your mind. Make sure that you want to move ahead. Be satisfied with what you have. And don't concentrate on what you don't have. Because you'll never, ever have enough, according to Oprah Winfrey. And I agree with her on this. So stop wasting time. Time can never be replaced. This is not a waste of time. We're here to motivate you and inspire you. Hopefully we're doing that. I'm not going to keep rambling. I'm going to move along. Hope you all have a great day today. 24-0, Lori Johnson. Oh, Miguel, I need you to cut that for a second. Lori mentioned her son, and I'm not sure what's going on. Oh, Lori, okay, what's in the cup? You know what? I'm glad you asked, because yesterday, after the show yesterday, Anthony and I had a little talk. Nothing's in the cup. You know, you people roast me sometimes about being a little overboard, but I said on Tuesday I wasn't talking about it anymore, and look what happened. It fell apart. Now today, he's always got, not excuses, reasons, but there's nothing in the cup. He let it drop. So we'll try it again on Monday. I'll come up with some clues. I'll go ahead and run it next week, and then we'll give it back to him the week after. Let's just see how this goes, okay? So I do want to do something right now. For those of you who are like-minded, I am going to say a prayer. Those of you who aren't like-minded, don't believe in a higher power, you might want to log off now, because I'm going to do a quick prayer here for Lori Johnson and her son. Okay, here we go. Heavenly Father, we come before you now, Lord, and before your grace right now. Lori Johnson has reached out saying that it's not a good day for her right now. Something's going on with her son, and Lord, you know what's going on with her son. You know what's going on with this virus. You know what's going on with everything in this world. You are truly in control of things, Father. And sometimes we don't know what your will is for us, but we know that your will is always good for us. Father, I ask for a hedge of protection around Lori and her son, whatever they're going through right now, Lord, that you just intervene and do what you do best, and that's showing your love to the world. And we thank you, Father, for all that we have and all that we are. It's in Jesus' mighty name these things I pray. Amen. So, Lori, that was for you and your son. Give me a call later if you need to talk, stop in, whatever. Have a great day, folks. Miguel, you can hit the music again. We're back to ending the show. Thank you. And have a good one, folks. It's a choice. And wherever you go, whatever you do, that's right. Do it in a Subaru. We'll talk to you tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. for your weekend update. On behalf of Anthony V, I'm Subaru Steve, and you just watched the Subaru Steve Anthony V Show without Anthony V. Later. Miguel, it's over. There's nobody there, man. The show's over. Why are you still playing the music, dude? Cut it. Cut the music. Thank you. Man, the show's over, dude. Just because Anthony V's not here, you got to act a little strange? I don't understand it sometimes, man. Sometimes you're like a little overbearing. I just don't know what's going on. Oh, now I got to clean up the room because Anthony V's not here. Great. Great, great, great. Well, let's see if I can find some music to listen to for a moment. Let's see, a song that never ends. Okay, let's see. Something inspiring.
And yes, it goes on and on, my friend. Just because.
Grammarly ensures your writing is mistake free.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide.
No escape from reality.
Open your eyes. Look up to the skies and see.
Have a great day, folks.
Mama! Just kill the man!